Morning, guys. I am going to talk about angle relationships. Again, this unit that we're in is a lot of dealing with definitions, and we're going to then apply those definitions in the next unit. So you're probably going to take some notes on this. So we have vocabulary. Congruent is anytime you have something that is the same or equal. So two angles that have the same measurement are congruent. Again, congruent is just another word for equal in math. Vertical angles, and I'll talk a little bit more on the next slide, are opposite from each other and they are always congruent. And again, I'll come back to vertical angles, but take a moment, pause the video whenever you need to so you can write down those definitions. They're opposite angles when two lines intersect, and vertical angles are always congruent. Then you have adjacent angles. These are just next door neighbor angles. They're right next to each other. They're side by side. They share a common vertex and array. So again, they're right next to each other. They may or they may not be congruent with one another. Complementary angles just mean two angles that equal 90 degrees when you add them together. And then finally, supplementary angles are two angles whose measures have a sum of 180 degrees. And I think I've talked a little bit about that in class, that a straight line is a straight angle that's 180 degrees. So two supplementary angles, when you add them together, form a straight line, and that's 180 degrees. So what does that mean? So actually, I think this other picture here. Let me get the pointer. Okay, so now you can see the pointer. And so I'm going to point out this angle here, A, or I'm sorry, C O D, angle cod right here. Okay, we have a vertical angle with this angle, and it is directly across. So what it means is I have this vertex, this is directly across, so A O E. So they're like right across from each other, these two angles, this angle here and this angle here. These are vertical angles from one another. So that means if I were to put a protractor on this angle here and this angle here, the measurement is going to be exactly the same. So what that means is if I was given the measurement of COD and they told me it was 44 degrees, I wouldn't have to do any other measurements since this is a vertical angle. By definition, this would also have to be 44 degrees. So this is probably the most confusing one, but we have the vertical angle. We have congruent angles. So angle B O D and B O A, those are congruent. They're both looks like 90 degrees. There's no symbol to indicate that, but they both look 90 degrees. So we're going to make the assumption that these are both 90 degrees. These are congruent angles. Also, by looking at it, BOC and COD, this looks like it's almost a 45 degree angle. Could be really early in the morning for me, but those could be congruent as well. That just means they are equal to one another. Again, vertical angles are by definition congruent. For the adjacent angles, that just means they're right next door to each other. So BOC is next door to COD. They share a common vertex, they share a common ray. So these two angles, this angle here and this angle here, are adjacent, just like COD is adjacent to DOE. So this angle here and this angle here are adjacent to one another. And I could continue going that this angle is adjacent to this angle, and this angle is adjacent to this angle. It just means two angles that are right next door to each other, they share a common vertex and a common ray. The other two are supplementary or complementary. Complementary are two angles that, when you add them together, equal 90 degrees. We have one set here. We have B O C and C O D, these two angles, when you add them together, so this angle here and this angle here, when we add them together, make a 90 degree angle. So they are complementary to one another. So two angles add up to 90 degrees, share a common vertex, they are complementary. Now, then supplementary is two angles that when you add them up equal 180 degrees. I think the easiest one here is AOB and BOD. When you add these two angles up, we've got 90 on this side, we've got 90 on that side. So when you add it up, they make this straight line. It's almost like that half of a circle, right? They make half of a circle here. So these two make 180 degrees. There are other angles here that also make 180 degrees. They might not be as apparent, but for example, COA and AOE also make half a circle and also equal 180 degrees. So a lot of this is definitional. Take a moment. Stations will be out there for practice. We'll go get over this again in class, and we'll get a lot more detail on how we can actually then utilize those definitions to determine unknown angle measurements without having to necessarily bust out a protractor. That's really all I have for you today, guys. Thanks so much.